Gamers from across the nation, hello. Welcome to Gamers Paradise. On this very special episode, we are watching...
Spending most of us living in the Gamers Paradise.
We are watching the Nintendo Direct. It's going to be a very special one today, folks. I hope we're going to hear a lot of news about the video games we love and care... Oh my God.
What?
The Nintendo Direct was sick
for one moment. Shit. Whoa. Mario's hacking.
Nintendo's gonna get him. I am joined by Fanbyte's brand editor plus Nicholas Grayson. Hello.
Yo, what's up?
How you doing?
I'm good. I took a nap that was way longer than I expected, and then the sky opened the fuck up a couple of seconds ago. But you know what I did do?
What did you
do? I got a wireless headset. Whoa. In the mail. And you know what? Hold on, watch this.
Oh, you can't see me.
I mean, you sound really far away.
Yeah, perfect.
But you can hear me perfectly. Okay. Do they have a headphone inside?
What?
Do the
microphone?
Yeah. Oh, sorry. A microphone inside.
Yes. Oh, yeah, they do. But I don't have that plugged in because it looks weird.
Mm.
You know what it does have, though?
Mm-mm.
LEDs.
Okay.
Like, I don't know why. I can't see them. They're facing forward. They face the screen.
So if you're exploring like a dungeon or something in real life. Oh, let me turn both of us up.
LEDs nuts. Thank you, Imran.
LEDs nuts. Very thank you for the active chat, everyone.
Yeah, I really appreciate that.
LEDs nuts. Yeah, let me know if we're too loud or too quiet. I can bump us up again. But I'm excited to check this out.
Me too. I have literally no idea what's happening except for Kirby. And when I found out that Kirby was happening, I started crying.
Why did you start crying?
Because I was like, well, now the surprise is ruined. I was so sad.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, it was the worst thing that's ever happened to me. That I found out that a JPEG of a new Kirby game was released.
Yeah, I was very sad this morning. I actually did see a lot of talk about that whole Kirby situation.
It was really weird.
Yeah.
I
think that's the moment you realize that video games writing and journalism in general is just so different from every other medium.
Yeah, exactly. And it's really weird. Mm-hmm. It's also like, it is news that a new Kirby game is coming. But to be mad about finding out that a new Kirby game is coming from Nintendo, the people who make Kirby, does not make any sense.
Yeah,
don't get mad at the people who are writing pieces about news. Don't do that.
The part, like, I understand if people are reporting on like a leak or something and you're upset about that, there's a huge spoiler, I guess. But if it's a leak by the company and like they did it on their own
Nintendo's website,
it doesn't make sense to me at all.
Don't get mad. Come on. Be glad, you know, like the trash bags.
Mm-hmm. So what is everyone in chat expecting? We see Automatic Gold here saying, I expect some pretty hot news. Something
like sexy or like...
I think there's going to be a Kirby game where he's just a pile of lava.
Whoa. Like Alex Mack.
Yes.
Bayonetta 3, that's an interesting idea. I have fucking no idea. Because here's what I actually think. I think I said this to Steven the other day, yesterday, and Steven can back me up on this. I think there's going to be Animal Crossing, like a reasonably big update to Animal Crossing.
Better be.
I think Brewster's going to come back.
They got those Animal Crossing fans fighting for scraps.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, because it's like they forgot about the game.
Mm-hmm.
I think Animal Crossing, I think Merritt said that the last Smash character is going to be Joust, and she was right last time, so
yes.
I guess it is going to be Joust.
Fortune teller Merritt is definitely true. I'm so hyped about Smash Bros. Like, I installed my... Hey! Oh my gosh, retry. Thank you for the follow. I installed my Switch again with the GameCube controller set up. Oh my god, it's starting!
Sorry, I'm watching a fucking advertisement for Disney. Rated M.
Let me know if the audio for the stream is too loud or quiet. I will change it for you.
Oh, you know what? I shouldn't watch our stream. I should go on YouTube. And...
yes.
Because then I'll just hear myself. Imagine a stream where I could hear myself, you know?
Oh, shit. This dragon looks familiar.
Monster Hunter. Why is it so wet?
Yeah. This dragon's also looking mad mean.
Be less mad, dragon. It's not that, nothing's that serious.
Monster Hunter, Rise Sunbreak.
That doesn't make any sense. But this is, I guess, the Iceborne.
Yeah, equivalent. I said it weird. Monster Hunter Rise, Sunbreak.
There it is.
I made it more weird than...
saying it differently makes it different.
Yeah, yeah.
No, but yeah, that makes sense.
Hello, everyone.
There he is.
I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi, and I'll be your guide for today's Nintendo.
Hi.
Hi. Are you good? You look like you're tired.
Trailer for Monster Hunter Rise. Sunbreak, the massive expansion for Monster Hunter Rise.
This game is still coming to the personal computer.
Capcom are working on many new elements.
It's not out there yet?
Enhance the experience for players of Monster Hunter Rise, including new stories, locales, monsters.
I really wish there were captions. There aren't.
New hunting
actions. Are you watching on Twitch or YouTube?
Twitch.
If you, Monster I know Hunter this is going to be a pain in the ass. They're on YouTube.
As paid okay. DLC captions. In summer 2022. Please stay tuned for more information.
Do you have a link to it so I can just open yeah, that and right. That'd
Let's
be perfect.
Our first batch of Nintendo Switch.
I'm
going to
put
headlines.
It in chat.
Cool. Thank you.
Party during the day.
Oh, finally
night.
A new Mario Party.
It's almost time to party. Party in the Mario Party Superstars game. Along with Spaceland and Peach's birthday cake, several other boards make their return. Take a stroll around Woody Woods, but watch out for those Monty
Let
moles.
Me resize this real quick.
They'll change the board's direction when you least
time
expect
for this,
it.
Nobody gives a
Travel between
shit.
Two islands and Yoshi's Tropical Island.
Stop.
Toadette's got the star, but she might swap places with Bowser at the last second.
Perfect.
Party day and night really in Horrorland. That King Boo statue is harmless during the day, but at night, it'll swipe stars from unsuspecting players. Need a break from boards?
Hey, it's
Head
Toad!
To mount minigames and play in
Let's go!
Courses. Compete against players worldwide for the longest win streak in survival.
Speaking of Toad, you think maybe
or
Captain
work
Toad
together
too?
In the cooperative multiplayer.
Captain Toad, dude, maybe.
Mount minigames?
Maybe. Yeah, I want a new Toad experience, though. They kind of pigeonholed him into just being an adventurer.
A puzzle adventure boy.
Yeah. He's much more than that. John is saying, cancel this game.
I agree.
Mario Party Superstars launches on the Nintendo Switch system October 29th. Pre-orders.
I feel like every time we talk about Mario Party, it gets heated.
Well, it's because we're right.
I know.
A new RPG is in the
I know. A new RPG.
Welcome to Voice of Cards. Voice of Cards. Okay. Is it a card building RPG? It's a Fire Emblem.
A oh, reckless
no.
young
look
man.
Look at that guy. Look at that. Look at that guy.
What is this guy? Little Seal?
I don't know. I love him though.
At the queen's behest, you'll set off on a fantastical journey to slay a fearsome
what?
Dragon for honor and fortune.
Everything in this man. Realm is represented.
Why are you upset? This I know
That's
people who
I,
like.
It looks cool. This is not what I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be a deck builder. It is a deck builder, but I thought it was going to be a deck builder, like third person
and a little bit
action
of luck.
Game. But it looks like you build maps and then play Hearthstone.
Yeah, I'm not a card person, but I don't know. The designs look cool.
Yes. Oh, it's a Yoko Taro joint? All right. I'm back in, baby. Saito is about
to unfold. This will be my first Yoko Taro game.
Mmm. Voice of Cards. Yeah, Clarissa makes a good point here.
Oh, launches on Nintendo Switch
October 28th. Pre-orders and a free demo will
be available today on Nintendo. They gotta say like 2024.
Yeah, just that's give, next month, dude.
Give us a break.
Oh, you heard of this game? A hero
or an Let's go! Disaster of a human being. Final Cut on Switch?
Yeah.
You awaken in a hotel room in the city of Revachol, devoid of your memory.
I can't wait to hear Nintendo Man soon, explain how this game works. Entangled in a
strange murder case. Oh, not
where
him!
Where he can't talk about any of the content of the video game. As you interrogate people and uncover
clues, internal dialogues will begin. Ah, oh, man. I want to wait till I forget more of this game so I can replay it.
Me too. I didn't finish it the first time. Your behaviors and available choices will change
depending on how you develop. Yeah, I played it, directly impacting how the story when Final Cut dropped earlier this year. For the first time, like, I ran through the whole thing. One of my favorite games. What sort of Nintendo man talk about snorting speed?
Yeah. The Final Cut go read Renata's physical version piece over at Kotaku that she put out in her first week.
Pre-orders for the digital
version if you want a little refresher on uncover more stories in Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity. Damn. Did you play this game?
No. Okay. I have a friend who plays all of these games. Like,
I tried to play it. It's such a frustrating visual and performance experience that I was unable to finish it.
Rough. Kirby, what is up?
What's
How
up,
you doing?
Kirby. What a good handle.
It is nice. It rolls off the tongue. And about that courageous friend of yours. I do like that these are building out the world.
That Breath of the Wild set up. You're pretty good for a little kid. We better Yeah, it's just the game runs at such a low frame rate. It's basically unplayable.
Yeah, I'm hoping to see some Smash Bros. Stuff. Mm-hmm. A reveal, the final reveal. I'm hoping for A, Among Us. B, Fortnite. See, I'm serious. I'm not capping.
Oh wait, you're saying put Among Us in Smash?
Yes.
Oh, I thought you were saying release Among Us on the Switch, and I was like, it's already out, though.
No. Yeah, I want that or Goku or Master Chief. I'm going big. It's the last one.
Yeah.
Thank you for the follow, Callahan.
Yeah, Oishi is right. A Switch Pro is just around the corner. We're really close to that Switch Pro. Yo! This Chocobo has roller skates!
What is happening?
Who the fuck is this lady? Yeah, show me the Chocobo!
Is this the first time they're revealing this? This looks so wild.
I love this dude. Fire. Collect these throughout courses to cast magic like fire
and arrow to blast away opponents. Wow.
Yeah, then you get to do Final Fantasy spells. Even more powerful
spells. Yeah, this is fun.
Yeah, so they just made Mario Kart, huh?
I don't also have special
ability. It looks slow. Use
it
at the right time
to turn. It does look slower.
But maybe this trailer is at 50cc or whatever the equivalent is.
Oh, true. I hope the stages look cool because for right here it's not too impressive.
Nothing about this says Final Fantasy to me.
No, it seems like Final Fantasy characters in like a Mario Kart setup.
Yeah.
But, you know, they could do a lot with this. There's so many great environments in FF.
Mm-hmm.
What did you think?
Yeah, there remains. Show you our next video, oh, why did Moobot do that?
I don't know.
Sorry, Moobot. Or sorry, Remora Vox. I don't know why Moobot did that.
Next video, we have some news about the last fighter for the Smash Bros. Ultimate game. Sakurai, the game's director. Let's go!
No. It's tomorrow. No, they're telling us to come back in October.
He'll also show you how to use this fighter, so please look forward to it.
Okay.
It's been about 3 years.
Like a substitute teacher, I'll wait.
This will be the last presentation of Super Smash Brothers Ultimate. I hope you'll check it out.
I cannot wait to say I'll wait to my first class. Now, it's gonna be so great.
Take a look at this.
I'm glad they got it out of the way though, so we're not just hyped the whole time. Yeah. Something.
Okay, Splatoon. I think.
That's a good call. It was like a post-apocalyptic world.
But this looks more cel-shaded than Splatoon is. I think this is Kirby.
Oh, yeah. No, this is the Kirby. Yeah, look at the buildings.
Is there an open world? Breath of the Curb. Curb of the Wild.
Kirby Odyssey.
Curb your enthusiasm, but it's K-I-R-B.
Ooh.
Wow. Yep.
He is very cute. Oh, the run!
Oh, yes. Well,
Kirby and the Forgotten Land.
Damn, so it really do be...
Who is that?
This is like, this is just like The Division.
Let's see the powers. I want to see his cool powers.
Do anything.
Kirby's be shopping, for real.
Did you ever think you can jump?
I've heard he can jump, he can float.
You think there's going to be a mini game mode where you can do air ride shit because these maps are so big?
Gotta be. Or some kind of like transportation.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Was he?
That fucking got me.
Wait, why are you freeing Waddle Dees?
He switched sides.
Oh, the classic cut.
Yeah, baby.
Oh, wow. Kind of turn into like a Gordo?
Whoa. What did they do to Donkey Kong?
This guy looks like the Ring Fit guy.
Ooh. He does. He looks like Donkey Kong and the Ring Fit guy had a baby. Spring 2022. All right.
That's enough time.
Yeah.
That was the trailer for Kirby and the Forgotten Land. In this new game,
whoa,
you can move around in 3D areas,
like jump,
using familiar Kirby
and climb
moves. The setting also,
I really like this.
Serious. I do too. I really like the way this looks.
Mm-hmm. Civilization. And it's such like a huger environment for Kirby, and it was not chugging. Which
it was not chugging.
Nintendo likes to show games even when they're chugging, and this wasn't. So that's cool.
Next, we have this to show you.
I will. Thank you.
Please take a look.
Oh shit, it's sad.
Yeah, baby!
Oh? Also,
yeah,
Nick,
baby! It's Rooster! Let's go!
I think you're 1 or 2 seconds ahead of us.
Bro. Oh shit, sorry.
No problem.
Oh my fucking, come on!
Since its launch in 2020, the ever-crossing New Horizons game.
Hey, they're making stuff.
Around the world.
Chill.
New free content.
It's free. It's coming.
In preparation for its release, we will be airing an Animal Crossing New Horizons Direct in October. In it, we'll go over the content
right.
And more.
Animal Crossing folks get their own Direct. Good for them.
That's good. I'm happy. I
appreciate
it. Please
be on the lookout for the air date of this presentation.
Let me turn on my light. It's getting dark.
They have now, Funky, they have announced 3 video games and 2 other Nintendo Directs in this.
Yes. What's that?
2 games, 1 game update, and lots of fun. 4! More free content is coming to the Mario Golf Super Rush game.
I'm going to pause my stream
Troopa enters the fairway
and then count to
character.
5, and then hopefully that'll bring me back into
dish out tricky shots.
Thank you.
And dashes you. To yeah. Mess with the competition.
This game has Ninji will also been pretty cool, and I like that. Oh, Ninji! This is a new character.
Of Ninji's blinding speed.
Oh shit, Ninji's here.
I've been playing a few of these, few matches of these, like each update.
Mm-hmm.
It's not bad. But I'm just not a golf person.
as a
free software update later today.
Stupid dumb thick. Thank you for the follow.
Thank you.
What's this? An invitation.
Oh, today.
You're invited to live in a magical world with Mickey Mouse
and dozens of Mickey
Disney
Mouse.
Characters.
Who the fuck?
Spend
who
time
the
with
fuck
Disney
was
friends.
That? Oh, to me.
Don't you remember this classic Disney character? All downloadable weird looking me.
Wait, these aren't me's. Crucially, these are not me's. Enchanted Edition.
Source onto Nintendo Switch. These look more like Xbox avatars.
A beloved Star Wars game is coming to Nintendo Switch.
Blast this was a 3DS
to captivating
game.
Captivating planets and join forces with Jedi, droids, and outcasts.
Wait, this is just the older one?
No, this is the remake. Will you use the Force Nintendo got it first. Or will you be lured to this is what it looks like. Your choices determine the galaxy. It looks like this now.
I don't think that's true.
Yeah, this is the original. Switch,
pre-orders begin today.
I never played this, but I heard a lot of good things.
Me neither.
Is it a thing?
Yeah. But that's the thing, right? Like, I don't. Do we play this one and then play the new one?
No.
Or do we wait for the new one?
I think I'll probably just.
Humanity's last stronghold against a virus that turns people into the undead. In the cloud version of Dying Light 2, Stay Human, you'll need to master both parkour and tactical combat to survive in this brutal open-world action RPG.
You ever try this one?
Alone. Yeah. Here's what I can say. As you unravel the dark under zero circumstances would I play this game over the cloud.
Plunder the layers of the infected at night. Your
because it's a
story,
precision parkour platform with stealth mechanics and zombies. And it's a first-person shooter.
Oh, like you mean on the Switch? Like you wouldn't?
Yes. Yeah. This is not a local version. It's a cloud version.
Dying Light Platinum Edition. Scavenge for supplies, craft weapons, and face hordes of the infected in a post.
Was he biking on like a power line?
Yeah.
Cloud version launches on Nintendo Switch February 4th, 2022.
Wait, what is cloud version?
Demo will also launch.
Cloud version means that the game, there's no game. You connect to a server. And then you play the game like it's an xCloud.
No.
Begin today on Nintendo eShop.
But Dying Light 1 is the regular version of the game.
Utility, morality,
which is why it looks so bad.
Gotcha. Yeah, Detroit Become Human. You know that guy's making a Star Wars game? They just keep giving him chances?
They keep giving him chances.
Good God.
Your actions will lead you through a riveting story that changes based
stunning
on the decisions
HG
you make.
Stunning HG2D2DBH.
Where will your conviction guide you?
This is really fucking pretty, though.
Yeah.
I cannot follow.
In response have to you the played demo released in February called this year?
Octopath?
The game has been no, it's the Final Fantasy. It's the guy. It's the game from the Final Fantasy, dude. But it's on the adjustments to the difficulty. It's on the iPhone.
Improvements to on-screen visuals.
No.
Somebody in chat. Controls. Fantasian, yes, thank you.
The ability to review previous dialogue.
Nice.
And
oh, yeah, Remora Vox, you are correct. When they announced this game, it was called Triangle Strategy
more
Working Title. They did not come up with a better name.
Oh, I thought it was Project Triangle.
Triangle Strategy will launch on Nintendo Switch.
Oh, you're right.
March 4th,
that's a better title than Triangle Strategy.
Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo.
It's got a fire, though. Dread Metroid.
Day.
I think I'm gonna be Metroid build. I finished.
I think I'm gonna try this one too.
Yeah, I finished Super Metroid when I had no Wi-Fi for a week, and now I'm just like hyped on her.
I love Metroid and her adventures. I hate how I don't know what the word is, but that robot moves like liquid and I hate it. It's so creepy to me.
Super viscous.
Yeah, it's so creepy.
Moving around like a. I should play the ones on Game Boy Advance. Which one? Let me know. I will download that.
What's it called? Metroid
Fusion?
Samus Fusion. Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Garrulous Monolith hits it right on the head there. It's a Boston Dynamics looking ass.
That's exactly right.
Yeah. Like after years of being kicked over, they're fighting back.
Yeah, and folks who are calling this motherfucker a Bionicle too are also
Samus
correct.
The most powerful bounty hunter in the galaxy embarks on a new mission to the Uncharted.
I'm pretty sure that's Metroid.
Her objective?
Zitter.
Confirm whether the deadly X parasite still exists.
Zidia.
Figure out why the Emmy research robots in search of it have mysteriously gone dark.
Oh God.
Oh, is that what the is that what happens when you lose at the Emmys? It turned into that?
Each with its own elements and organisms. Remnants of the mighty Chozo civilization are also scattered throughout
organisms.
Evidence that the Chozo may have once called the planet their home.
This is their home?
Metroid.nintendo.com.
It used to be Metroid Egypt. That's wild.
I don't think it's Samus's voice. Because they were like, this is Samus's story.
Be sure to view the other Metroid Dread reports there as well. You'll want to prepare yourself.
Do you, were, at any point, did you, like, go to the Nintendo website for news in your life? There was a period of my life, like, when they were announcing the roster for Brawl.
Probably DSi era.
Yeah, they were announcing the Brawl roster, like, once a character every 2 weeks or whatever, at, like, the same time every day on the website, and you would just be sitting there refreshing to see who was coming.
That's the life, though.
In addition to the current membership, we'll be adding a new membership plan.
Nintendo Switch Online is the biggest scam in the world.
Yeah. No, but new content is coming.
Content. Oh,
oh, you
damn.
Have to pay more money for it, though.
Well, that's why it's new content.
Yeah. Is it Game Boy Advance? Oh, no. GameCube, Nintendo 64.
Oh, this is cool.
It's a Nintendo 64.
Nintendo 64 system launched 25
I don't.
Years ago.
That's not what I want. I mean, this is great. Their first
3D game and we're charging $90 for each game.
With Nintendo Switch, up to four people can play.
They're gonna
fucking
Nintendo put
64
this out.
Games locally.
You know what's
online.
Fucked up, Funke? What?
What's up?
They
also,
have
this new membership plan.
You know, Pokemon.
The Nintendo 64
I've heard
game, of this.
Mm-hmm.
They have all of those games. On the Game Boy Advance.
Mm.
Oh, okay. Now hold, the fucking phone.
They got you with the Genesis.
Now hold the fucking phone.
Play these classic games whenever and wherever you'd like.
Mm. I mean, people have been asking for this for a while, because like they have all the files.
Yeah.
Online membership.
Elvi can finally play Sonic.
Included Nintendo 64 and Genesis games.
I'm just trying to understand how you.
This is
wait,
Nintendo
so they,
Switch
it's an expansion pack.
Expansion
they
pack.
Chose the Nintendo 64 and the Genesis, but
this
not
new membership plan
the,
will be added
not the fucking
October.
Sega Saturn or the
of course,
Game Boy Advance.
Be able to continue using the existing plans.
Why did they pick the Nintendo
also,
64 and the
an existing membership
Genesis.
Plan can change over to the new plan. We'll share more
Daytona.
Details about this new membership plan at a later time, including the exact release date and pricing information.
Yeah, somebody in chat did say that
you'll be able to play the Nintendo 64 game shown here.
Oh, they could only find 9 fucking ROMs. Jesus Christ.
We'll also continue adding more.
They don't even okay,
games,
listen, folks.
Zelda,
you don't
Max,
even have Sonic 1.
As well as other Nintendo.
Like I understand that that's not the best
forward.
One.
Mm-hmm.
Pokemon Snap.
Shifty
okay.
Disco says that's it.
Furthermore,
welcome to the chat. Shift.
Welcome to the chat. You're right. Paper Mario good
with the same style controls
oh.
from their original releases.
How?
Okay. Okay. I'm back, baby.
Can be used wirelessly.
Let's go!
Can you fucking imagine telling a person in 1990 goddamn 3 that
member.
Nintendo was eventually going to start making Sega Genesis controllers?
I hope you look forward to this new membership plan. Nintendo Switch Online. $50!
Bruh.
And let's you know that fatty controller is going to have the drift. All the way down.
Yes, of course.
It's gonna have the three.
Are they gonna sell the fucking glove?
Oh, I hope so. But I mean, they charge so much for these apparatuses, and then they break, or are just already just broken from the start.
You'll explore a dystopian future where magic has reawakened and fantasy creatures have come back to life. Immersive branching narratives. skill-based character.
This game is fun.
And gripping turn-based tactical combat.
I remember playing the start of it and it just like exploded my mind with the intro.
The perpetual struggle against Count Dracula continues.
Oh?
Castlevania Advance Collection brings together four classic Castlevania games with deathly beautiful graphics and hauntingly epic music.
Oh, this looks sick.
The Rewind.
This does look sick. Save, do you know what the box looks like for the DS version of this game?
No.
All the box for the DS version of this game is a screenshot of
Vampires.
Is a screenshot of the other DS version of this game.
An almighty classic returns.
So instead of it being the box art, it's a picture of the box.
Oh God,
on the cover. A Final Fantasy game?
The classic Super NES game.
Fillmore?
Returns on Nintendo Switch.
Fillmore looking different.
HD. As the Lord of Light and Almighty God, only you can save mankind from the forces of Tanzra, the Lord of
Darkness. This is HD?
You'll wage war in two phases.
First, what do you mean?
Strike down monsters in the side-scrolling action phase.
I don't know. It looks good, though. What is Actraiser?
Master swordsmanship and magic to vanquish all who stand in your path.
Actraiser.
Cultivate the lands you've liberated.
It's you know it, you love it.
Phase.
It's I don't know.
Decide which structures will be destroyed to make way for new ones, creating a flourishing civilization.
Okay, cool.
As you do so,
everybody in chat
will increase, giving you an edge in both phases.
Oh, it's got tower defense.
It's the best SNES game.
Versions of the beloved soundtrack and enjoy brand new music. New stages and new boss battles also.
Oh,
await.
I love that shit.
Actraiser
when they let you do
onto Nintendo Switch later
when they let
today.
You switch back
today.
Wow.
A new chapter is about to unfold.
What?
I was playing this.
A second Deltarune? Oh shit.
Oh, what the fuck? Oh my god.
That was terrifying. I started playing this yesterday on stream. Very fun game.
Yeah, I need to play the first one. How long is chapter one, do you know?
I hit up Imran and he was saying like 2 to 3 hours for each.
Oh my god, that's perfect. I love that.
Mm-hmm. And they're free. Like,
yeah.
These are feel like full games. 1 and 2. Oh, look at the dance. Look at this little
Kobe's
dog.
He's got so much money.
Yeah. I heard about some of those figures, like, whoa.
Yeah. Toby just drowning in those zeros.
You played a bit of Hot Wheels Unleashed, right?
It's hard to say. Let me check my email to confirm whether or not
sorry.
I did. Give me 1 second.
Of course. I meant you were playing the Hot Wheels, the toys.
I have, I've seen a lot of trailers for the video game Hot Wheels Unleashed.
Of course.
And it looks pretty cool.
Well, it's coming to Switch.
It is coming to Switch. That's really good. I'm really excited for that.
A few more announcements in today's Nintendo.
I'm really excited for that team.
Oh, Miyamoto-san.
They did put Pac-Man in that.
So I was hoping I
oh my god! Oh. Whoa, what are you doing?
Everybody, shut the fuck up.
Hi, everyone. I'm Shigeru Miyamoto.
Everybody, he's wearing Mario's
we
shirt.
Previously announced that
they're
I
not in the same
with
room.
The
everybody,
Hollywood
shut
movie
the fuck
Illumination
up. Hi, Miyamoto.
And its CEO and producer,
hi, Dad.
Chris Meladandri-san.
Hi, Chris.
Is he about to show the fucking trailer?
No way.
Who the fuck is this, lad?
Animated Mario movie.
No.
Is he dead? Why are they showing this picture?
Stop. Blackjack, thanks for the sub.
The movie will be released
all in 2022. Okay, in a year.
The release Ta-da. Date for North America is on December 21st, and we'll be announcing release dates for Japan, Europe, and other regions.
This is awesome.
It'll be a while longer until we can share a glimpse of Mario in action on the big screen.
Damn.
But today, I also wanted to reveal our key
thank game. Thank you for the sub!
Not Jesus Christ. Oh.
First,
no! No, 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 no!
bro. We lost, bro. We lost. Pack it up. We fucking lost. No way. No way. This guy. Get him out of Taylor. Oh, she's
Get
good.
The fuck down.
I can't wait to see a very spirited Princess Peach.
Oh, get the hell out of here.
God, get the fuck out of here.
Ah, wait, what?
What the fuck?
I'm excited for you to see this.
What is this dress? What is going on? What are you talking about?
Monster performance by Jackson. The comedian.
What is happening? This is fake.
I'm looking forward to great comedic
what
moments.
What do you mean?
Even though this is
no,
a Mario Donkey Kong will
the
also
fuck
be
he is.
He will be played by Seth Rogen. And of course, Charles Martinet, who has voiced Mario and many more Nintendo characters.
Cut the cameras.
Over the years, is also involved.
Dead ass. What is happening?
Oh my God, Charles Martinet, the most important man in our company's history, is also involved.
Other beloved characters.
Oh.
No fucking way, Fred Armisen.
Cranky Kong.
That is all I can share with you today about the Mario movie.
Oh my God.
This is a very collaborative project between Illumination and
Nintendo. Am I high? Hey, are we high right now?
I think we're both high and dead.
Enjoying a creative process that is a little bit different from making games.
Bruh.
It may be a while until we can share more updates, but I hope you look forward to it.
Yelling so loud. I'm so fucking mad, dude.
Please look forward to Mario's adventure jumping into
Holy
the world of motion pictures.
Holy fucking shit.
Next.
What did we just... What did we just experience? You can't move on to something else. What's going on?
God. I don't give a shit about Splatoon now. You fucked up. It's too late. It's too damn late. God.
They were just like, who are 10 people we can cast for this movie? Who are 10 actors in the world alive right now that we can get together?
But now hold on. I am going to just Google famous people. Let's see how long it takes me to get to any of these motherfuckers. Oh my God.
Hi, Oshi. Nintendo Direct, full of surprises. I need some water.
Yeah, TH Box says that the order in which they did the fucking reveal is like...
Boom.
You know that TikTok where the person is like, they get shot and then they throw their whole body back and they learn something else and they throw their whole body back again and then they like keep going?
Yes.
Oh my fucking God, dude.
Boom. Oh my God.
This Splatoon 2. Splatoon 3 looks good, I guess. It looks like a Splatoon. Wait, what the fuck? Wait, no, why would you do that? What? Is she okay?
Hello, everyone.
You can't follow this, bro. That should be the closer.
I've been meticulously studying the mysterious squids that can transform into humanoid form. What you just saw was the latest research
footage. This is legitimately the wildest direct they've ever
done. Allow me to share.
Literally 2 minutes before they announced that Charlie Day was fucking Luigi, they said that they were making Sega Genesis controllers.
Centered around Splatsville are the Splatlands.
I feel like they don't realize how
sea creatures such
as nuts what they just revealed was.
Buildings spanning several generations are crammed into the city, creating its distinctive culture. In the Splatlands, turf war appears to be a popular activity.
Its basic rules are unchanged. Nikki, Splatoon. Player teams
compete against each other. Yeah, I didn't play the first one. Area. Because the trend I didn't have a Wii U. A major
shift.
And I didn't play the second one because I was in school when it came out and I didn't have time for a shooter.
In the latter portion of the footage,
I'm excited.
We were able to observe activities from story mode.
What about you? Single player
campaign. I played a bit of the first one when it dropped for Wii U. Because I was one of the 10 people on Earth with the Wii U. And yeah, it's very fun. Of story mode this time cool game. They have a very cool like lobby system, like walking around where people can draw stuff. For two cats. Reminds me of like the Nintendo Universe stuff or whatever, where you could
Miiverse.
I think so. Still a lot to uncover. Yeah, that's a really cool system.
But we'll continue with our research and keep you updated once more results become available. Please look forward to more. Splatoon 3. Updates to come.
I can't
see you next time.
Fucking believe.
I'm gonna see all of their faces in my dreams. What did you just
say?
Like wanted posters just plastered.
They couldn't get them to do a Zoom call. Future updates. Like,
okay, this is the last trailer we have to show you today.
That's it.
Please take a look.
I'm ready, man.
Oh my god.
Platinum?
Yeah, it's Bayonetta.
B-b-b-b-b-bayo. Dog.
Oh, yeah, there she is. That's Bayonetta. Yeah, it's Bayonetta.
Man.
I started playing Bayo a couple months ago. I think it was this first one? Fun combat. I don't know how... Yeah?
I don't think they sent enough guys for this.
Yeah. I love army guys, though. They're always like, no matter the media, let's just shoot them. I know it's come from a different world, but we got this.
Yo, we have bullets. Those always work. Fred Armisen is Cranky Kong.
What? Which time? Oh!
Oh shit, not the pig, dog, whatever, no one knows. Shit, it's Bayonetta.
Bayonetta doesn't give a shit about the human men that passed away, but does care about this fake dog.
Good for her.
I appreciate it.
Oh, she got a new haircut?
She got a new haircut. Late. She went to the GTA barber.
It's looking clean.
It is looking clean. Witch time.
Oh, what is... On the subway! You can catch these hands anywhere.
I love Shang-Chi.
Whoa. Oh shit, that scene was crazy though.
That scene was nuts.
That was wild. This is Bayo 3.
Damn, that part where he was on the outside of the fucking bus though.
Oh my god.
Holding onto the pole. That was
yeah.
So cool.
No right.
Yeah.
Whoa.
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 Is that the Sheikah logo?
Where?
On her back? In the middle? It looked like it.
Maybe. I don't see any Zelda references otherwise, though. Yes, huge shout out to tall women. Doing great work out here.
Brian Brent says Kristen Bell is about slated to play Bayonetta in the Mario movie.
I love how you can say any form of words and
put
an actor in there.
Anything.
I'd be like, true.
Denzel Washington is fucking, I don't know,
Yoshi.
Yoshi, yeah.
That was a huge battle at the end, though.
Is Chris Pratt gonna do a voice?
Don't even put that thought in my head.
Is he gonna do a fake Italian voice the whole fucking movie? Or is he gonna sound like Chris Pratt?
Wow, some things aren't worse than other things. They're both equally evil. What you just said.
We announced this game in 2017, and we thank you.
Yeah,
for
if Chris Pratt did an Italian accent, is that racist?
Yes.
We hope you look forward to Bayonetta's new encounters.
DM filter said, stop leaking the script. You can't do that. Nintendo's gonna fucking get you, dude.
I shouted so much during that Mario reveal.
Did anybody clip that?
The French people on the street. Back. We do. Please
go clip that if you didn't. Oh my fucking god.
Well, we.
Noel Funke, now listen. Mm-hmm. What do you think about that Nintendo Direct?
One of the most fun Nintendo Directs I've seen.
I would agree.
They did pull two things. We both came in wanting Animal Crossing and Smash Bros. And they announced
announced other directs for both of those.
Hey, we know you want that shit, but let's save it for another time. And then they dropped that bomb I forgot they were making a Mario movie. Straight up.
I also forgot. But here's the thing. I now understand why they didn't put the Animal Crossing and Smash news in this one.
Yeah.
Because the real conversation is this fucking movie.
Yeah. Wow. How is he still
Chris Pratt?
Yeah.
Yes. Because most of America still likes him.
No.
Also, he's still in the Marvel movie, so like his window hasn't closed.
Wow.
They announced that they were releasing a second tier to their subscription service, and that second tier, which will cost more money, will give you nine Nintendo 64 games and like 12 Genesis games. They then announced afterwards that you could spend $50 for a Sega Genesis controller or a Nintendo 64 controller.
They're running our pockets dry. And
I hope they give you the glove.
They would have shown the glove if you're getting the glove.
But then if they put Mario Party 1 on the fucking eShop, then what? Then they're going to have to send the gloves out again? And just cut out the middleman, put the glove in the box. Xenophon brings up an incredibly cursed concept that Bowser is done. There's definitely going to be a musical number because Bowser is Jack Black.
You may be right. I'm going to pull up the cast.
Yeah. Jack Black is the only character that is the only person where I'm like, that actually tracks.
Mm-hmm. And he's a gamer.
Yeah. Jack Black as Bowser is like, I would say, approaching inspired casting.
Mm-hmm.
And so does Anna Taylor-Joy. As a woman of color, Anna Taylor-Joy being Peach,
I'm sorry,
doesn't make a lot of sense.
Bring you back there. As what?
As a woman of color, Anna Taylor-Joy, perfect, as Peach makes a lot of sense.
Thank you for the follow, Mab. She's a great actress.
Yeah, and a woman of color.
One of these things are true.
No.
Okay.
Hold on, wait.
I don't know if you're serious or...
I'm going to put the link in the chat. Hold on.
This one was a sucker punch to the senses.
Yeah, that would hurt so much. That was like Miyamoto went inside of my brain and hit me.
Yeah, Jack Black, I could see.
Variety, in early March, described Anna Taylor-Joy as a woman of color because she is Scottish and Argentinian. Seth Rogen is Donkey Kong. And then Charles Martinet is also fucking here. Can
this
you
line up?
Keegan-Michael Key is Toad.
He's taller than all of them. Okay.
Fred, who the fuck is Sebastian Mescalero?
I don't know. I don't know these two, but Spike is a character, Kamek. Wow.
Actually, I know that guy. Sebastian Mescalero, or whatever that dude's name is. He used to be the warm-up dude for Stephen Colbert, the Late Show with Stephen Colbert.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Huh. So, do you like his work?
No, he was fine.
Okay.
The guy, the black guy in the guy who's Kamek,
mm-hmm.
was the genie on Broadway in Aladdin.
Okay.
He was very good in that role. So nice. The kind of tracks that they would make him Kamek.
Do we think there are going to be musical numbers in this then?
We have a few singers. I would argue yes. Now here's the thing, right?
Evil Image.
Original songs? Or are they doing modern?
Listen, no. Continue that thought. Are they doing...
okay.
You actually Mario... before this went Mario... live, you sent me a TikTok mm-hmm. of a Bella Porch song in Mario.
Mm-hmm.
And it was fully animated. And now, you didn't send any text to that message, you just sent it to me.
I just sent it to you.
Is it gonna be similar to this?
The camera pans up. Hold on.
Mario.
No, the camera pans up and there's a lot of dust, right?
Yeah.
And you see very slowly there are steps being taken. Mm-hmm. And it pans up and it's Mario and Luigi each on their own Yoshi. And then this starts. And then they both very slowly move through the dusted Mushroom Kingdom.
Stop. You can't give them these ideas. They'll do it. They'll wholeheartedly do it. So you think they'll do like gamer?
I don't know. I have no fucking idea. Like, that's the thing. Like, I thought I knew what this movie was going to be.
Yeah.
Which was just a DreamWorks movie. Got Mario in it. But now it could be fucking anything.
They pushed Charles out of his many roles. It seems like he is the supporting cast.
I would be so fucking pissed if I was Charles Martinet. Like, unbelievably mad.
Yeah. Like, he helped build this. But yeah, no, and I could see them doing kind of like a Weird Al-y gamer twist to a lot of popular songs right now.
Bruh, but why isn't Weird Al in this movie, though?
True. Cameos, though. We don't know every character. Like, who are some major Mario characters they didn't talk about? Yoshi is not on here.
Yoshi's not on here. But Yoshi doesn't speak. But neither does fucking Mario. So, you know what? It doesn't matter. Like,
Waluigi, Wario.
Waluigi's not here. Wario's not here.
Daisy.
Oh, hey, what's up? Who's in here? What's up?
Hey.
Welcome to the... Hey, what's up, Imran?
Hey,
why didn't you tell us about this shit?
I told you this shit, and then they went into like some of the stuff I told you guys about. They're like, "Hey, we'll do directs for this later." I'm like, "Fuck!" Now I can't. Like, I have pre-written stories that I can't use right now because they're like, "We'll just do these own directs." That what the fuck ever. What I want to talk about real quick,
yes,
is that Bayonetta trailer is hilarious because it's like five different platinum teases just to try and make you mad. Like, it's really? Literally like, oh, so they have a game that's a big kaiju battle game that they've announced but they've not shown. So immediately it's like, oh, it's that fucking kaiju game, huh? Then they show the Astral Chain dog, which is like, oh, it's a fucking sequel to Astral Chain. Then Bayonetta comes out. It's like, oh, finally. So they knew what they were literally trolling you for about a minute of that trailer.
Oh, like if you're a deep platinum head, like you're like, oh, what's this? What's that?
Yeah.
Also, yeah, that is the voice of Imran Khan, our news editor at fanbyte.com.
Welcome.
Hi, Imran.
If you somehow did not watch the rest of the stream and want to see what's on the direct, I just put up a story.
Yes.
Wow, on fanbyte.com?
On fanbyte.com.
Can we get a link in that in the chat? Yeah, we were kind of just talking over everything and then just fell out of the world when the Mario news dropped.
Yeah. Yeah, that's... I didn't expect anything different because it's a big Hollywood movie. So, of course, they're going to have big Hollywood stars. Chris Pratt is fucking weird.
Yeah.
It is whatever the opposite of an inspired casting choice is.
It's like the default. It's like someone sat on a couch and found Chris Pratt between the cushions.
Yes.
It was like, yes. Okay,
yeah, we'll put him in the movie. Also, Lazarus Handshake said something fucking cursed. She said Yoshi is going to be Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Oh. Oh, I can see it. That, yeah.
Yeah, come on. I cannot. I can't.
What if you get that guy who's in all like the Aaron Sorkin shows? The guy with glasses.
Oh, fuck. Not Jeff Daniels. Okay, Jeff Daniels in this movie, though, that would be good.
Jeff Daniels should play Bowser. That should be the actual thing.
Jack Black, I don't think he'll do Bowser badly.
I don't think anyone here is going to do bad. I think, like, we'll see the trailer and be like, oh, this is fine, but it's also a little cursed.
Yeah.
I think Jack Black is going to put in the only good performance in this motion picture.
Are we talking about the new hit movie of 2022?
Mm-hmm. We are.
The greatest animation feature to ever grace motion pictures, Mario.
Charlie Day Luigi.
Very good.
Is like...
Luigi.
Is the new cellar door, right? Like, there's not a more beautiful phrase in the English language now.
Yeah, Charlie Day Luigi. This is gonna be a sleeper hit, and it's definitely overshadowed by all of the other castings, like Seth Rogen Donkey Kong, and Keegan Michael Key Toad. But I think he'll do a great job.
All of this sounds like something that, like, you know how you go to a bar sometimes, you're like, oh, well, who would you cast in this kind of movie? This is
after you've had 45 fucking drinks.
This is that kind of cast. This is what they did at Illumination, is like three executives got really hammered, went to like an Applebee's, and they're like, yo, who do you fucking like from Mario, man? I just saw Tomorrow War. Let's get Chris Pratt, man.
The Keegan-Michael Key thing is like, I already know what joke that's going to be. It's going to be the angry Obama.
Yeah,
like, as Toad.
It is.
Like that's already boring. Like,
that's already boring. It was good one a time.
I hope he tries something new there. Or does voice. High voice or something.
Well, Chris Pratt uses normal voice.
That's what we were trying to figure out.
Mm-hmm.
I think he will. I've never heard him do like an accent, like a real, like an attempted accent. Him doing like an Italian accent just sounds like even more hell to me.
Yeah, I'm coming around on Seth Rogen as Donkey Kong too.
Mm-hmm.
That seems fine.
I think there are three good castings. It's Charlie Day Luigi, Jack Black Bowser, Seth Rogen Donkey Kong.
Who is playing, like, I know the name they gave for Peach. Who is that?
That's the
Queen's Gambit.
Queen's Gambit.
Okay.
She's the queen in Queen's Gambit.
She's also in...
It's a demotion.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now she's a princess.
Oh, you were setting that up.
It was really good. Oh, yeah. She's also the Vivitch.
Yes. Movie. Great movie. And she's in the new Edgar movie. What's the one where, like, she's going back in time and she's living the life of someone else and then she's stuck in time. I don't know the name, but.
It's called. Hold on, I'm looking it up because now I want to know.
While Nikki is looking that up, let me remark: ActRaiser looks like shit.
That's what I said, and then Funky was like, "What do you mean?" I was like, they said it's in HD, and I said, "Really?" And then Funky was like, "What do you mean?" That movie is called
Last Night in Soho. Sounds right.
Last Night in Soho. Also, she's Furiosa in Mad Max Fury Road 2.
Wait, what? Isn't that Charlize Theron?
No, but it's a prequel.
Oh.
Why would they not just have Charlize Theron for that? Now I'm mad about Mad Max Fury Road 2.
I didn't even know they were making a Mad Max Fury. Why are they ruining Mad Max Fury?
Money. It's coming out in 2024. So they have enough time to cancel it.
John has clipped the casting.
I might have missed it because my inner eardrums like exploded when I heard Chris Pratt was playing Mario. Mm-hmm. Is Mario's a real voice actor in this movie and they just didn't give him the role?
They gave him supporting roles.
He's supporting roles.
He doesn't even have a name as a role. Yeah.
Yeah, it's just Charles Martinet.
I hope he's like Chris Pratt's dad.
They said Mario's surprising dad. Cameos. So what I'm hoping for is that Charles Martinet plays Sonic the Hedgehog.
Whoa. Ooh.
He's got range.
They get that Sega Nintendo multiverse stuff going.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, because Sega's very protective of Sonic the Hedgehog.
Yeah.
They clearly would not let him be in anything.
And then Doctor Strange is here and he starts opening up some portals. And then Tails says, on your left.
On your left.
He fucking comes out.
Wow. That would be fun.
How are they going to depict the murder of a Goomba in this motion picture, do you think? Where do you think the Goomba's going to go?
It's going to be a thing where Mario, like, jumps on one. He's like, hey, man, what are you doing? And, like, oh, it's the joke everyone's in. I expect a decent level of college humor. And by that, I mean collegehumor.com.
.com.
Yeah, like those Flash videos they used to do of Mario.
Yeah. God, hold on. I have to write an idea in our Slack and not put it on fucking the internet.
Now, what do we think the plot of this movie is going to be? Do we think it's going to be like very like self-aware of everything? Do we think it's going to try to take itself in some sense serious, like as far as like the story?
Mm. No, it'll be a children. It'll be like the Wreck-It Ralph of a thing of like there's going to be like this emotional like thing at the end, but other than that, it'll be largely self-aware.
Yeah,
I just can't get over the fact that they already put Bowser and Mario in a good animated movie, Wreck-It Ralph, the first one.
No, Mario is not in that because they were saving Mario from.
Oh, you're right. Mm. It's just Bowser, huh?
Yeah,
yeah. He was at the villains meeting with Zangief.
Yes, apparently, yes. Zangief is there. That's right.
They wanted to use Mario very significantly in the movie, and then it was like, we don't feel super comfortable with that. And the reason was because they were planning this thing.
So they decided to hitch their fucking horse to Illumination instead of the company that makes money every time they make a movie.
Khalif is coming in chat with the most cursed take.
Get out of here, Khalif. No. End the stream. Turn it off. We're done. Turn it off. I have to go.
Yep.
Thank you so much for hanging out. For the most cursed Nintendo Direct that will ever be.
Yeah, this is fun, though. Thank you, everyone, for watching. Check out all the coverage on fanbyte.com. You can check me out on Twitter at FunkyFly.
You're going to make a fucking Pokemon movie and make Jeff Goldblum Ash Ketchum.
Please.
I would watch that. Nikki, that is brilliant. What are you talking about?
Nikki, I would pay what people would call an unreasonable amount of money to see Jeff Goldblum play or just talk about or just say Pokemon names.
Jeff Goldblum as Professor Oak is the one thing I think I need.
Where can people find y'all on the internet?
You can find me
nowhere. Oh, okay. Don't find me anywhere.
You can find me on Twitter at Godsewa, GodSewa.
You can find me at Beguiled Gamer on Twitter if you want to just, I don't know why you'd want to do that.
Because you'd be tweeting.
Yeah, just tweet. Tweet.
Yeah.
Tweet so much you forget any of this happened.
And Imran, where can people find you?
You can find me on Twitter at ImranZUMG or currently writing a tweet on the Fanbyte account.
Let's go. Yeah, everyone have a great night. And, just try to forget about that casting. We're going to be living through that soon, I guess in the next holiday season. Later, y'all.